Trichy Siva.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chairman, sir. Sir, when the chair expects us not to interrupt, sir, we expect that we need not be interrupted.
5 minutes.
Sir, I deem it a privilege to speak on the 255th sessions, commemoration of the 255th sessions of the Rajya Sabha as a member of this august house. Sir, I don't want to spare my time, which is very limited, to Anandasayan Iyengar, Gopalaswamy Iyengar, or Nazimuddin, who have all spoken in favor of the second chamber in the Constituent Assembly. I'll come straight to the point. I got one or two points to make, I want to insist here, and some reforms which, because the subject of this today's topic and debate is that the role of the second chamber in Indian polity and the need for reforms. Sir, a bicameral parliament at the national level is the defining factor of our constitutional functioning of governance, fundamental functioning of governance. And the framers of the constitution have established this second chamber or the Rajya Sabha or the Council of States not only to have a second look on the legislations but also to obviate hasty legislations. That everyone has made a reference of, and of course the Rajya Sabha has played a pivotal role in the making of laws and as a deliberative body. So any legislative forum functions on its own procedures, codes, on conventions and customs. Though the constitution though the constitution has provided some codes and rules for functioning of the both the houses, both these houses have evolved new codes and procedures by way of experiences and interactions. And this house, sir, is a very good sample or representation of the federal setup, because as any every other member has spoken, the states, this is called as Council of States, and those people who can contribute to the society or to the nation at large and who are not in the thickest political fray or who cannot or doesn't want to enter into the electoral fray, this house gives a space for them. And of course the members representing the states, they reflect the situations in their states, and the domicile of representation, which has been routed or outed by in the 2006 judgment in Kuldeep Nayyar versus Union of India, that of course deprives the importance of the federal setup, because that means that a member should come from a particular state. When that is removed, anybody can come from anywhere else, and he may not have any interest on the particular state he has been elected. So he must be a voter of that state from which he is elected. But that has been, in that case, I think it turned otherwise. So with all these things, sir, there are many things to be mentioned here. And Sarkaria Commission has also said again the importance of the upper house, rather the Council of States. Sir, my suggestions here to be considered are, number one, the private members day, which is slated on Friday. See, even in this house today in an afternoon, all the members, sometimes we, if we count for quorums, sometimes the house has to be adjourned. And on Fridays mostly, that on the Friday afternoon it is meant for the private members day, most of the days we suffer for quorum and only 4 or 5 are remaining. So I may suggest, if at all importance has to be given for the private members legislation, that day has to be moved forward in any of the weekdays. And if the government legislation is put on Friday, at least the treasury benches members would remind that, because they are interested in the government passing legislation, so they would make their members to remind. So it's a very important suggestion, sir. We call it as a private member day, but no importance is being given, and you easily take it off. So it could be moved forward to a weekday, and the government's legislation could be taken to Friday. And second, sir, select committees, earlier the standing committees, of course, they go through the bills, and sometimes even if there are some lacuna or some bills which have not been referred to the select standing committee, we suggested to send it to select committee. Sir, earlier we used to decide in the chamber, and the government will also agree, But now it is put to vote here. They say the majority. If that happens, no bill will go to the select committees. So if some members, some political parties insist, it is not in the interest of any particular political party or any particular thing. It's only in the issue. So if some political parties in the House suggest for a bill to be sent to a select committee, that could be considered by the government and it should not be put to vote by way of your majority or by wooing some political parties in favor of the political ruling party. Nice. And third, sir, the number of working days are very less. We don't even work for 100 days. Sorry, we don't even work for 75 days. In a whole year, the parliament is not working even for 75 days. The House of Commons in Britain, they are working from 150 days to 200 days. There they are not paid salary like us per month. Even if they attend for one day, they are given something and they are content. If they attend the house, they will be paid. But they have worked for nearly 150 to 200 days. We work for only 75 days. And the time limited of working days is very, very less. And members' time is much more less. And the moment we start speaking and we come to the point, immediately the chair intervenes and says, stop, immediate. So what for we are here? It's a deliberating forum. The parliament is for debating, deliberating and deciding. And the member is not able to speak or vent his thoughts, vent his views, which are very important. Every time, sir, we feel it awkward situation that a member who is making a very relevant point, his throat is strangled. Kindly consider that. Of course, time is very important. Even for this debate, the chairman this morning in the chamber said, 4 hours is allotted for this debate. And if he said, if some more members are willing to speak, it could be extended, it could be relaxed. But the situation is not so. That's what I said. We agree that we should not interrupt the house. Of course, interruption is a part and parcel of the parliamentary democracy. Yes. But the members should also be not interrupted every now and then. We experience that. So that is also my observation, sir. And seasoned people who may not be able to be otherwise, they come here, they want to speak something, they contribute. Those things, considering that, the reforms, when you think of, my foremost suggestion is, kindly, sir, move the private member day from Friday to any working day. That would be
of points. Please conclude.
And second, sir, state upper house, like this, the second chamber is very important. My colleague, Mr. Navanitha Krishnan, was advocating for second chamber here, but his party was many main reason for abolishing the second chamber in the state.
Okay.
But sir, the parliament should take interest that every state should have a second chamber in their respective states. Thank you very much.